In Lightroom and Camera Raw, not all sliders are created equal, and they shouldn't necessarily be used the same way. There's two completely opposite functions that we can use in the tone slider. I'm going to show you right now. In this tutorial, we're going to focus on the tone panel, and I'm going to show you how the shadows and highlights are very different than the whites and the blacks. First thing we're going to do is I'm going to give you a tip. I'm in Lightroom right now. I'm going to click and drag. Notice the length of the sliders. Now we almost doubled them in length. Gives us much more control. By the way, this tutorial will also work the same in Camera Raw. So the first step in my process is bringing out as much detail as I can in the image. The second part of the process is I'm going to add the punch. What I like to do is not even touch the whites and blacks at the moment. We're going to focus on the highlights and shadows. These are recovery sliders. If I take the highlight and move it to the left, notice how it recovers color and detail, particularly in the sky. If we look at this without making the adjustment, see how it's kind of blown out? Now we're starting to bring it back. If I can't get enough highlight recovery, and of course you have to have the pixels on the sensor, I'm going to take the exposure and I'm going to pull it down a little bit. Notice we can see we've got color in there. That's looking good. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the contrast and I'm going to reduce it a little bit because this also increases the dynamic range. Let me show you. As I move the contrast to the left, notice much more detail is available in the highlights and shadows. If I go the other way, it looks punchy, but notice we're losing a lot of detail. And we're not going for detail yet. So let's pull this back just a little bit. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. All right, so we're showing detail in the highlights. Now we want to show detail in the shadows, which is areas like these buildings. So we're going to take the shadow and we're going to increase it until we get enough information. I'm not going to go all the way, but I'm going to go pretty close because this is a drone camera for very low dynamic range. If I was using something like a Sony A1, I wouldn't move the highlights and shadows as much because that picture has more dynamic range. So it is very image independent. But just remember, you're always taking the shadows to the right to recover the shadows. We're taking the highlights to the left to recover the highlights. This is what we're doing to recover information. If we look at it so far, before, after, we can see there's not areas that are just blown out to white or black anymore. All right, next thing we're gonna do is now we're gonna add some of the punch. And this is where I go into the whites and blacks. Now, if I hold down the Alt or the Option key as I slide the slider, as I move it across, you can see where it starts to clip. When it goes red, it's starting to lose information, but then when it goes white, it's blown out completely with no information at all. Now, I'm not going to go that far with this one. In fact, I probably don't need to do much with the whites in this particular image. So I am looking at maybe this area here in this atrium. See, I can get a little milky. Just pulling this up can clean it up a little bit. But in this particular image, we don't need a lot of whites. What we do want to do is we want to add some blacks to give it some punch. So we're going to take the blacks to the left. So hold down the Alt or the Option key and let's see where the clipping begins. So the clipping is going to begin, you can see right there, if I release it. So in that area of the rocks is where we're going to start to lose it. I'm going to eyeball it a little bit. I'm not going to take it all the way down there. I'm going to take it to about here. Now, if we look at what we've done, there's the before and there's the after. See, look at the sky particularly. It's really making a big difference. So I just wanted to concentrate in the tone panel. There's a lot of other things we could do with curves and different things like that to finish the image off. And in fact, one of the things I might do is take the texture up a little bit just to give it a little detail. See how that just makes it snap? I used to use clarity, but I don't like clarity. Let me show you why. Look at that. See how it looks sharper, but it just kills the colors in the image. Whereas the texture can show me that detail without damaging the colors and adding all those halos. So I'm curious if you found this tutorial useful. Let me know in the comments underneath. And if you want to see more about Lightroom, check out my Lightroom new features video here. If you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button. Turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.